Good afternoon, sir. Today we are presenting a topic, non-deterministic and deterministic finite automata. We are four group members. Our group leader is Nilutpal Ghosh, but unfortunately he was suffering high fever, and also Somodip Sen and his family suffering high fever. So me and Sion presenting this topic. So please consider this. First, I would talk about deterministic finite automata. In a DFA, we describe deterministic finite automata in a DFA for a particular input character, the machine goes to one state only. A transaction function is defined on every state for every input symbol, only input symbol. Also in DFA, null or move is not allowed. Null is not allowed in the in this graph. DFA cannot state without any input character, and also DFA can be represented by five tuple Q, finite set of states. Summation is a finite set of symbol called the alphabet, and the sigma is the transition function where the input. And the Q0 is the initial state from where any input is processed. F is the set of the final state. There is the 1 is the final state. And next, non-deterministic finite automata. It is the similar of NFA and DFA except following addition features. Null and move is always allowed. It is similar as DFA, but is one changes in the 5 tuples. Is one changes in sigma. Where the transaction without function is where sigma and summation is 2 to the power q. And then our next slide is different between DFA and NDFA. Where the DFA's diagram is Q0, Q1 and Q2. And the input symbol is 0 and 1. Where the input symbol 0, we jump to the Q1. So it is understand the DFA. NDFA, yeah, there are same two symbols 0 and 0. So we are not decided where to go. So it is NDFA. And the next slide is NFA and DFA. And the first question, consider the language L given by the regular expression. And the regular expression is A plus B whole to the power into B, A plus B over the alphabet A. B, the smallest number of states needed in a deterministic finite state automata, DFA accepting L is. And the option is 3, 4, 5, 6. And the answer is B, 4. Why? The first we write the expression A plus B whole and into B and A plus B. First we expression to convert into NFA. First we put A as A plus B, we put into A and B, and second is B, and we put B into the B, and the A plus B, and B to C, A, B. And after NFA, we are minimizing NFA to DFA. So it is the table of NFA to DFA, and final state is the diagram. There are four L, A, AB, AC and ABC, and ABC is the final state and C is the 5. Answer is B, 4, the 4th state. And next slide is, under which of the following operation NFA is closed? Negation, mean, concatenation, none of the mentioned. Option is answer is D. Explanation, NFA is said to be closed under the following operation. Because under the following operation, union, intersection, concatenation, knee and negation. So answer is B. The next slide is, which of the following do we use from NFA from regular expression? Always we are used to Thompson construction method. We are all know that Thompson construction method we are used to regular expression. Next slide is number four question. Given arbitrary non-deterministic finite automata in FA with n states, the maximum number of states in equivalent minimize BFA at least. We all know that the number of NFA contain n, then the possible number of states in possible DFA is 2 to the power n. We all know that. And the expression is given there. And so the answer is 2 to the power n. Subset construction method refers conversion of NFA to DA. Expression is the conversion of a non-deterministic automata into a deterministic. One is a process we call subset construction or power set construction. Number six, now next slide. For DFA accepting binary numbers whose decimal equivalent is divisible by 4, what are all the possible remainders? So the 4 divisible by all the numbers are 4 divisible by 4. So expression, all the decimal number on division would lead to only 4 reminders. Only 4 reminders, 0, 1, 2, 3, property of decimal division. So the answer is D, 0, 2, 3, because it is divisible by 4. Our next slide is the maximum number of transition which can be performed over a state in a DFA. Summation 3, A, B, C, there are 3 alphabet. And the answer is C. Why? Explanation, the maximum number of transition, because their transition is 3, A, B, C. So the which of the DFA allows language in the number of elements the transition constitute. So the answer is 3. There are 3 transition. And the next slide is given language ln assumption 0, 1. And then symbol for the right in x is 1. How many states are required to execute L3 using NFA? The answer is B, 15. Expression, the finite automata automation for the given language is made, and thus the answer can be obtained. But the answer and the expression is not given because it is a huge procedure. So I do not so I can cannot make you. The maximum sum of in degree and out degree over a state a DFA can be determined as summation ABCD. It is also verify language to language. NFAs accept regular languages. The answer is D, depends on the language, because it is verified. The ABCD is the alphabet, so it is verified language to language, very only language to language. Expression, the out of degree DFA I fixed, while the in degree depends on the number of states in DFA, and that cannot be determined without the dependency over the language. Only it's varied to language to language. Example of NFA, this is the explanation, this is the example, and this is the diagram, and where the starting symbol Q0 and the next symbol Q1 and the final state Q2 were input into the input symbol 0 and 01, and the transition diagram we convert into a table where is the table present state, next state, and next state 1 and 0. We put into the 0 Q0 Q0 to Q1, and the we put into the 1 Q0 into, so the example is Q1, and that Q1 put into the 0 Q2. There is the same thing. And the example of DFA, the question, W is a string that does not contain consecutive ones. Solution, where 3 consecutive ones occur, the DFA will be here 2 consecutive ones or single. First one is acceptable, hence the state Q0, Q1, Q2 are the final state. The DFA will generate the string that do not contain consecutive first line 10 110 101, etc. And the example is Q0, Q1, Q2, and Q3. First one is we put it in the one input symbol 1, and then after this is the diagram, and the final solution diagram is Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, where the input symbol put 1, 1 0 0 into we put the zero symbol into this diagram. Thank you, sir. We'll stop presenting this topic.
Very good.
Thank you, sir.
Very good. Thank you very much. You had a short
time.
Thank you, sir. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.